This video is going to discuss electron dot diagrams and polyatomic ions. Let's start with electron dot diagrams. You've also often seen in class where I have drawn an atom and you draw the nucleus and then the first level of electrons and the second level of electrons. And that works, but the larger the atom gets, the more complicated that gets. The electron dot diagram is a way to easily draw atoms and covalently bonded molecules. For example, drawing a chlorine atom gets rather complicated. You've got the nucleus and then three different levels of electrons with electrons 2 in the first energy level, 8 in the second, and 7 in the third. It gets a little bit complicated. To draw an electron dot diagram for chlorine is much easier. You just take the chemical symbol Cl, capital C, lowercase l, and that element symbol represents the nucleus and all full energy levels. So it represents those first two energy levels. We then draw dots around it to represent the outer energy level, the valence electron. And since chlorine has 7 valence electrons, you draw 7 dots, and that's it. It's very easy to draw a chlorine electron dot diagram. It also makes drawing molecules much easier. For example, here's an H2O molecule, and instead of having to draw all those electrons and oxygen, we just draw the element symbol for oxygen, O, and it's 6 valence electrons represented in green here, and the 2 hydrogens with the single electron they have, and you can see how they share. Oxygen's happy with 8, each hydrogen's happy with 2, and we have a covalently bonded water molecule. Now you might say, well, geez, that's really not too tough to draw if we drew everything out, and I would agree. Here's another easy one, a diatomic molecule of hydrogen. Probably the simplest one you could possibly have to draw since hydrogen only has 1 electron. So you might say, well, why do we need electron dot diagrams? It's not that tough to draw these things. Well, how about this one? Carbon tetrachloride, 1 carbon atom surrounded by 4 chlorine atoms. If we had to draw this out as the full set of electrons in their energy levels, it would look like this. So once again, what do you think's easier? The electron dot diagram or drawing out the atoms one by one? I think you'll agree that the electron dot diagram now kind of makes a little bit more sense. It's a lot easier. Let's move on to polyatomic ions. Occasionally we have a really unique thing form called a polyatomic ion. Essentially what it is, it's a covalently bonded molecule that acts like a single atom when it's around other atoms. That seems like a pretty long and poetic sort of definition, but that's exactly what it is. For example, let's show you hydroxide. Hydroxide is 1 oxygen atom bonded with 1 hydrogen atom, and you can see it here in electron dot diagram form. Problem is, this is a polyatomic ion, and the problem is it's still missing 1 electron. This is not a happy set of atoms yet because we're still 1 electron short from oxygen being happy. So here we have a covalently bonded substance called hydroxide that's still short 1 electron and really wants to get one. So if it can pick up 1 electron, say from sodium, sodium wants to give away 1 electron. Sodium gives away its electron to the hydroxide ion or molecule, and now it's an ion because it has 1 more negative than it does positive, so it's a negative charge. Sodium's a positive charge now. Opposites attract, and we stick together in a substance called sodium hydroxide, a very common household substance that's also known as drain cleaner. And essentially what we have here is we have the polyatomic ion of hydroxide, which is 1 electron short, picking up that 1 electron that sodium really wants to get rid of and bonding in an ionic bond here. Okay, so that's what we mean by a covalently bonded molecule that acts like a single atom one short, one electron short in this case, when bonding with other atoms. So we have sodium hydroxide. If you were around when we dropped the sodium into water in the classroom, this is what happened. We had sodium metal dropped into water, and the resulting reaction, which you saw in class, you saw hydrogen gas being released and sodium hydroxide being formed. This is a chemical reaction right here with sodium and water. And we'll show you this in class, and you'll also learn a lot about these chemical reactions and how to write them and balance them in future classes. So there you have it, polyatomic ions and electron dot diagrams.